Hi, welcome to Mica Tutorials. I am Mica Motwani. Now, so far we have learned how we can make use of auto-wired annotation to inject a bean inside another bean implicitly rather than providing the configuration information in the beans.xml. So we had seen an example where we were having the employee bean which had a property of type address, and we wanted this address bean to be injected implicitly in this employee bean. So therefore we had used this auto-wired annotation with the property address here, that is with the setter of the property address. We can use it with the setter or we can give it with the property also. Both will work in the same way, but only one of the property of this employee bean is getting injected implicitly. And in XML file, we need to register our employee bean, we need to register the address bean, then the injection was taking place. Now in this tutorial we are going to learn the component annotation which can be used to automatically register the bean. In that case, we need not to register the beans in the XML file. Rather than that, we will use certain annotations to declare a class as a bean and to specify the values of the different properties of that bean. So what we will do, we will just simply copy this project and make the required changes to learn the use of component annotation. So we will copy this and paste it with a new name. And then we will paste it and we will give the name to our project as component annotation. So we will change this name. And okay. Now when we will make use of component annotation, then in this case the bean will be registered implicitly. No configuration for bean will be required in XML file. We will close our previous project. And then this is our component annotation project. So we will expand it. Now here this is our employee bean and then second is our address bean. So let's start making the changes. Now what we want this particular class to be marked as bean by the Spring framework. So for that, here we will make use of @component. This component annotation is the stereotype annotation. And there are other stereotype annotations as well, like repository is there, controller is there, and so on. So we need to import this annotation from org.springframework.stereotype. Okay, and now to specify the values of these attributes, we will make use of value annotation. So we will give, let the value of ID be 111. We need to import value annotation as well. So we will import this value annotation, and similarly we will give the value for the name. So here we will again make use of value annotation, and here we will give the name. Let the name be Rahul. Okay. And for address, we have already given the auto-wired annotation, so it will be auto-wired. Now we will go to this address class and we want this to be also registered implicitly. So here again we will make use of component annotation. We will make an import, and again using the value annotation we will give the value of the attributes of the address class. So street, let's say XYZ street, and then we need to import this as well. And similarly, we will give the value annotation for city as well as state. Here I will just make the change. Let the city be Pune and state be MH for Maharashtra. So we have done the changes required in our beans in employee class and in address class. Now coming back to this beans.xml, Here we need not to register the beans explicitly, so we will remove these entries which were given earlier. Now what we need to do is that component annotation will be scanned and configured only when it is scanned by the dependency injection container. And for that we need to enable the scanning by giving a special tag inside this beans.xml, and that tag we need to give is the context component scan tag. So here we will give context component scan. Okay, and for this tag we need to specify the base package, which is the package from where the scanning for components should take place. Okay, so here our beans are in this particular package, so we will simply copy the qualified name of this package and provide here. Okay, so what we are specifying to the Spring framework, that this is the base package, or this is the package from where the Spring should start scanning for the components. If we will not give this particular tag, then the Spring will not be able to scan the beans that we have specified or that we have annotated using the component annotation. So to enable that, it is mandatory to give this particular tag. Now when we make use of this tag, there is no need for providing this context annotation config explicitly. That will be enabled implicitly if we make use of this tag. Okay, so no more changes required in this beans.xml. We have specified our base package, the package which contains the beans annotated with the component annotation. Now this is our client code, which we are not going to change. We are just creating the context and getting the bean and displaying the bean. Now here the name of the bean that we are fetching is employee. Now when we do not specify the name of the bean explicitly, the Spring will create the bean with the same name as the class name. Of course, the first letter will be small. So here it will create the bean with the name employee only. So let's run this code first with the default values only. Then we will see how we can give some other name to our bean rather than having the name similar to the class name. So let's execute this code. Now here we are getting the values that we have provided with the annotations. This is the ID, name, and these are the values for the address bean that we have given with the annotations value here. Okay. Now let's suppose if we don't want the bean to be created with the same name as the class name. So here we can give the different name along with the component annotation. Suppose if I want the bean name to be EMP. Now if I will run this test file, here I have asked to fetch the bean employee, which does not exist. So let's run this code and check out what do we get as an output. Now here you can see we are getting no bean named employee available because we have specified a name EMP over there with this component annotation. So we need to get the bean EMP rather than employee. So we will just change here and then run our code again. Now it is able to fetch the bean with the ID EMP. So this is how we can make use of component annotation. When we will not give any other name explicitly, by default it will register the bean with the same name as the class name, but the first letter will be small. And we can make use of these value annotations to provide the value for the different attributes of the bean. So this is the use of component annotation, which is a stereotype annotation and can be used to automatically register a bean. In that case, we need not to register the bean explicitly in XML file, but we need to enable the scanning by giving this particular tag. Otherwise, scanning of the components will not take place. Thank you for watching this tutorial.